he's not on the list, but there are some very big names, and they're stacked at the top, which means they're around about 7th, 8th, 9th in the semi-finals, so it's all the pressure there. But as you see, we got Martikan, Florence, Lefebvre, who's been going in all sorts of disciplines, and for the locals, Franz Anton, who's going to be going in the C2 tomorrow, at least in the semi-finals. So there's a top lineup here. First to go is Matej Benes. He didn't make the top three in the Slovakia team, so won't be going to the Worlds, but has been on fire recently, coming second 2 weeks ago when the World Cup team was in Les Odegaels. And take us away.
Yeah, Matej, one of the biggest blokes on the tour, long rangy style, really lopes his way down the course. You see him just coming over the start line here. So you've got a tight little stagger on this top section, which you won't win the comp on today, but you could lose it. See him pushing in, trying to get the boat running all the way in and out. It's a very boily eddy. The water moves a lot in that top up, but he's done very nicely, paddling forward, propelling the boat. And that's a good split from what we saw in the semi-final as well. Looking good.
And if you're tuning in for the first time, the idea is to negotiate your way down a 300-meter waterway, going through the gates without touching them. The green and white gates are to go downstream, and the red and white gates, that's the one you've just seen now, is to negotiate it upstream. If you hit a gate, that's a 2-second penalty immediately added onto your score. If you're deemed to miss a gate, that's a 50-second penalty immediately added onto your score. So it's really simple, really. Get down fast and clear.
Great work there by Matej. That's a really fun little gate there on the stopper on the white water, and he's delivered it beautifully, looking to keep the boat running. And here we're coming into the money move. Pushes it around, just ducks out. Good work. Get back on the front, mate. Matej's wife and young son with him here, supporting him running down. You can hear. Here he comes, flat boat in and out. I think that might have been a slight touch there. But here he comes sprinting. He's a DR champion, Matej, and so fast in a straight line. This is looking quick. Wow.
Well, that's certainly given the rest something to think about. As I say, it's stacked with top athletes. He'll be a bit annoyed at that 2-second penalty, SGS.
Yeah, I think he would have been right up there with a shot at gold without that touch.
Last weekend, or 2 weekends rather ago, when the ICF visited, let's say, the 1992 Olympic course, he was actually second, so it was a Slovakia clean plate. It could theoretically be the same today.
Yeah, it was a bit of domination last weekend, so I hope for the rest of the world's sake we don't see that happen, but never know. With this man following Matej down the course, Mikhail Martikan.
He's the legend of the sport, and so far this season he's been completely on fire, taking medals in every single competition.
Every time I ask him how he's doing, he always replies with perfect, and everything always seems to be perfect. So hopefully he'll have a perfect run this afternoon.
He looked quite relaxed in that semi-final run until he had a few mistakes, had two touches in the middle section, and then we saw the gun show come out. So let's see if he brings the guns straight away in this final. But there we have a touch coming in too tight, still very fast up. And as we saw in that semi, he's a man who can recover.
Martikan's a very gifted paddler in the technical front. He's always very clean around the poles, very, very in control. So I'm sure that touch won't have upset him too much. He'll know just to carry on with his plan down the rest of the course now.
Seems to have a new, fresh spring of life this year. Last year was a little bit quiet at 35 years old. People were saying, is that the end? But certainly he's proved this year by being the dominant paddler in his class.
Yeah, a new boat colour for the first time in 20 years. He's a new man. And he's paddling all white down here. Excuse the pun. Ducks out, charging through to the finish here. Just has to be mindful to keep his width into the last upright here. A lot of paddlers getting drawn in too early, but he's done well there. Feeds the nose up, squeezes under.
Time to go for his 100.0 second. Yeah, he's going to be close.
Very close. So he doesn't have the raw speed of Benes. Time ticking away. Just outside. Wow. So just 0.67 between the two Slovakians there, and their rivalry continues.
Well, they've certainly thrown down a bit of pressure. The semi-final time, the fastest pure time by Alexander Stafkowski was 98.11. He had 2 seconds of penalties that put him 100.11. So these two first paddlers are certainly giving the rest something to think about.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. It's been great paddling so far. Both of them will be maybe ruining those touches.
Next to go from the United States of America. This is great for a little bit of personal marketing. Say, watch me, because the world champions are coming up in 3 or 4 weeks' time in Deep Creek. This is Casey Eichfeld, who is competing in the C2 and C1 category. Hasn't quite got it together so far this season. Let's hope today is his dream run.
Yeah, Casey had a great qualification yesterday, qualifying third fastest overall. And he's got some raw speed. He's got some good technique. Just looking to deliver, running the boat around a little bit long there in the up there, so maybe not as fast as, say, Benus or Martikan, but looking smooth. Oh, and as we saw with the other two, the touches, and he's throwing the edge, trying to get it back online, but it's not fast.
He's picking up another touch there. He needs to get back in control of this run and hold it all the way to the finish now.
It's a great experience there for Casey in the lead up to his home world championships. So I know he's super excited. Very smooth in and out of gate 12.
Looks like to regain the composure.
Yep.
See what he moves, what move he chooses here on gate 18. Some people have been doing the S maneuver going from the river right side. And looks like he's picked up another touch there in the bow of his boat. And then some people have been choosing to do the breakout, as Casey just did then. I'm not seeing the splits yet, so which has been quicker? I think it's for the C1 certainly is a choice for which side they paddle on.
Oh, big boil there, just throwing Casey offline. And again, he's having to wrestle with the front of his boat, drives it out. But you can see there's a gap here between Martikan and Benus and Casey on this run, unfortunately.
Well, he's made the final, which is great. Goes into third place provisionally. Matej Benes, as you can see in the little winner's square, is giving Pilar de Claus because he knows how tough it actually is out there. Yeah. It must be quite daunting to have Benes and Martikan to go in the first two.
Yeah, definitely. It's a pretty ominous sight lining up behind them. But Casey, the poster boy of Deep Creek, he's got his own cardboard cutout stationed there, so... That's great work for them and great signs for him in the lead-up to the World Champs.
It's one champion after another. Denis Gargaud-Chenu was the World Champion in 2011 from France, and he's having a good season so far. He's fifth 2 weekends ago, let's say. See what he can put together now.
Silky smooth paddler, Denny. He looks effortless as he paddles down, but I can tell you he's putting some real power down through that blade. He's opted to go for fins on the bottom of his boat. Believe it was the Australians kind of revolutionising that in the lead up to London. So you're welcome, rest of the world. But very nicely done, pushing into the back of gate 11, driving out. And you can just see how his boat is always moving forwards. Slides his way, a bit of drift, Tokyo drift around the rock, around Moby Dick. In, out, and always has that pressure on the front of the boat, on the front of the blade. And I think we'll see Denny go for the S, being a lefty. So, yep, we do. Going to hold it tight, push up and out, a little bit caught.
Well, he was certainly up on the split by almost a second. Great pictures on the overhead. You just see the different swirls of these of the water.
It's really messy, confused water in the lead up to this last up here. Very tight. Just shrugs off that pole.
Well, so far he looks well in touch. Time to go for 100.07.
Yeah, I think we've got a new leader here by some margin. Wow.
Well, that's the fastest time of the day so far. first athlete to go under 98 seconds.
That was impressive, just smooth. That shows all the kids out there how to paddle. You don't have to go all guns blazing. It's about keeping the boat moving nice and smoothly. It's a great work there by Denny.
In fact, he was the first person to go clean there on gate 8 in this final. He just took the boat nicely around the pole and was definitely well away from that pole, not going to hit it.
Yeah, I thought he was a bit low actually, so showing that exit speed is maybe more valuable than a tight line in.
Czech Republic, 30 years old. It's Gervas.
Yeah, plenty of experience here, Vitislav. And again, a lefty, so paddles on the correct side of the boat.
Last year here, he came 21st, so whatever he does, it's an improvement today.
Oh, big, big boil there. You can see that water just flies down, and it's quite unpredictable, fluctuates quite a lot. Was there a touch there, or was it a water touch, I think?
Well, he's already nearly 2 seconds down and losing a bit of time on it.
Yeah, Augsburg can be quite cruel sometimes. If you get the wrong surge of water, it can really just upset your flow, your rhythm. But he's looking to work his way back here.
Yeah, gate 4 in particular, where you can just see that wave come up against him, is a hard gate. The poles actually change height on the water because the water goes up and down, surges there, and it's quite difficult. Certainly I found it difficult yesterday to get around that cleanly.
Yeah, it almost feels like the water's changing up to half a meter at times, so. But we see him coming down into the business end of this course, lefty, going for the S move.
Well, it's 4.5 seconds back at the moment.
Yeah, and he's low again there and having to really fight his way out.
See how he copes the torpedo waltz move, as they call it, I think, in Germany.
It's still not a bad time. And I think we could be looking at a close to 100 here. No, just outside, sorry.
Well, 102.9, an honest performance, but it's not enough to take a medal today. But this course is, it's all changing massively, but you all seem to know it very well. Robin, you telling me the first time you came down here was when you were 14, you're trumping Fiona, who was 15 when you first competed here. And it's I think it's been used 22 times now as a World Cup venue in 1998 to 2010. They didn't skip a year. David Florence is the world champion. He has really started this year with gold medal in Lee Valley, then had a couple of struggles. And let's see how he can go today. He's a good guy to watch, though.
Absolute powerhouse. Just watch the boat leap away off each stroke. Dave's certainly not one to leave anything in the tank. As you can see there, look at that. And he's just so strong and able to hold that the whole way down the course. There's not many guys who can hold that level of intensity.
Apart from his father, George, who you saw running down the course with him a couple of seconds ago.
Good genes.
Was an international for Scotland as well. Well, 1.22 off the pace.
Yeah, I think he, between gate 3 and 4 there, you can see he was having to really fight against the water. It looks like the water wasn't going really with him there. So hopefully the water will go with him a little bit better further down the course.
Yeah, a bit of give and take. Sometimes you might get a bit of bad water at the top, but the nice water might come back to you at the bottom of the course. And there you go. That's super fast, in and out, short lines, boat moving the whole way. So that's how to paddle C1.
Has he made up some time? Well, yes, he has. He's very much in touch. 0.16 off. The Brits having a stormy weekend. The C2s have all four crews qualified for the semi-finals, and obviously he's part of that.
Looking smooth down here. He seems to have found his rhythm. And he's coming. Sorry.
He got around the corkscrew move at 18 very well. Just one last move, quite hard as a righty. He's got out of there really well.
97.75, he's in touch.
Needs to bring that intensity. Come on, Dave, push it all the way. Just outside. but great time. So 98.57 for Dave. Very good signs for the world champs.
So just analysing the course, no penalties of time, but there's a couple of places that he might feel disappointed.
Yeah, I mean, there's a few little small places that, I mean, he was slightly offline, and most people wouldn't notice that, but I know that David will be noticing where those times were.
Look at that concentration.
Yeah, I think gate 3 to 4, as you pointed out, Fiona, was a big time loss for him. Just getting a bit of a rough end of the stick with the water. Here we have Takuya Haneda.
Made the final here last year. From Japan, of course.
Real contrast of styles. He's silky smooth, running the boat on those very short lines.
He was almost going too straight there between 1 and 2 and had to really duck inside 2. But he got his head and most of his boat in the line, so.
And again, you see that nasty boil, that nasty surge of water there, just messing with Takuya's chi, his line coming through into gate 4.
Well, 2 seconds off the pace.
Yeah, so he needs to keep driving the boat. As we saw with Dave, you can make a lot of time up on this bottom section. So he turns the boat, drives into 11. Little touch there on the outside pole just with the nose. He'll really be kicking himself there.
Yeah, slightly cares that he had sort of lost sight of where his nose was in comparison to that far pole.
Been based in Europe for many, many years, done a lot of training with Martikan.
Yeah, and you can see that there. That was a technician's dream, the up 12. So righty paddler, he's going to be going for the conventional upright.
4 seconds off the pace now, so it's just a case of pride and going for as much as he can.
And remembering that Denny's time is still quite away in the lead, so 4 seconds is still a very good time, and he could be pushing for minor places here.
The last difficult challenge of the day.
Well executed, but I think he might be just outside those minor places as well.
Well, third place is 100.07, so yes, he's just outside. But again, made double, another final. Well, we haven't had anyone apart from Denny who's really been delighted coming over the end.
Yeah, and I think those little surges of water have really been quite brutal to both Dave and Takuya at the top there. And it can play on your mind a little bit. As you come down, you feel that you're fighting the water, and Takuya does not regain his composure.
Good crowd today. So the weather hasn't been in our favour, but it's such a wonderful, iconic course. Fabien Lefebvre, interesting today because he was one of the last to go in the semi-finals for the C1 and one of the first to go in the semi-finals for the K1. He had about a 25-minute turnaround time. Didn't unfortunately make it through the K1, but obviously, as you can see, he's taking his good form through on the C1. Had a good result last weekend as well. Came 13.
Yeah, so Fabien, he's got the ability to paddle on both sides there. He can paddle as a lefty and a righty. Oh. Touched on the top hand on the exit, so cruel. And you can see here he's paddling on the left-hand side of the boat. I think from what I saw in the semi-final, he may switch it down the bottom, but choosing the left side of the boat as his predominant side at the top section in order to drive the boat on the upstream side.
Well, he's still in touch. He was 3 seconds down, but that did incorporate the 2-second penalty, so he's fast.
Yeah, definitely.
It's very smooth, just like he is in his kayak. He uses the water to his advantage and picks his lines very carefully.
Yeah, bit of a statesman of the sport these days.
He's certainly one of the busiest athletes competing on the Saturday.
Yeah, definitely. Another touch there. So maybe time just slipping away. And here you go. There you go. There's that switch I was talking about. So coming in, choosing the upright. Conventional for the right-handed paddlers, pushing his way down.
Yeah, so in between his runs during the semi-final, so he was running back up with his C1 about to jump in his kayak. He's probably still out of breath by the time he started his kayak run.
Well, still, after all that, 4 second penalties, it's going to be a fast pure time, but that's not the game, unfortunately. Well, 7.71 back. But saluting to the crowd again, we're going to see plenty of Fabian in the States, as he obviously represents the United States of America now.
Yeah. Yeah, says he's loving his time over there, and the American team seem to have really embraced him and loved learning from his wealth of experience.
Well, we now have 8 of the 10 competitors are down. We know that the leader so far, Denis Gagochenu, has booked himself a medal. But the next 2, Franz Anton, local experience, and Slavkovsky is unbeatable at the moment. Franz Anton, let's see, he's going in the C2 of Wales. Very keen photography expert, so he's almost busy.
Yeah, really nice guy, Franz. Just see him just chilling out at the river most days with his camera. But he's not bad in a boat either. You see him driving down here. He's got some good water as well. Oh, and just a small touch. Just running the line a little bit too tight into that first upright.
We saw that last year with the Germans. They either won the course or they were too keen and they bombed out completely.
Yeah, it's a bit of a shock this morning with his teammates really coming unstuck on the last upright, the gate 21. Oops. Another touch here, and he's fighting to get into the upright.
The atmosphere here in Augsburg, the locals all cheering him on, banging the boards.
Typically, yeah, they certainly bang their publicity boards.
Yeah, must be a great feeling to have all that support as you come down. Oh, that was flying.
Well, only 4 seconds of penalties, and nothing's impossible.
He knows this course, so he'll be using that experience.
Well, 4.24, that's the one that said no thank you.
Yeah, just going for a little bit too much.
Some unusual moves for Augsburg we're seeing here in the finals course. It's not surprising that the Germans aren't appearing as much as we would have expected in the final, because I think they're struggling with a few of these moves.
And again, that's the move that caught his teammates out in earlier today. Franz has said that's enough.
He must have done that move thousands of times.
Listening to them in the demonstration runs yesterday, they really weren't happy about that move. They seemed as though it definitely is not a favourite with them, and we've seen that today. They've all struggled.
Well, David Florence now has a medal. So, last competitor, Alexander Slavkovsky, he won 2 weeks ago in Le Saut d'Urgell. He won here last year. And he's been fast all weekend.
He's absolutely flying at the moment, Sasha, as he's known by his teammates.
Puts on a great display with the big whips, doesn't he, before the course starts.
Yeah, a bit of extra entertainment. Bit of a showman. Yeah, and we'll get ready for the show here.
What makes him so good? What are his characteristics?
Super flexible paddler. He's got quite a short paddle compared with everyone else, but long limbs, and he's just able to keep that paddle vertical the whole time and drive it from crazy angles. So, yeah.
Well, he's in touch. 0.6 down, as we said. In the break, the month that we had between Prague and Leto, he spent quite a lot of time skiing, so obviously he's used to putting his body on the line.
Yeah, loves his winter sports, Alex. And he's coming down here looking very smooth still, just holding a tight line there, which meant that he had to put the brakes on a little bit before gate 12. He's back in the flow. Looking smooth. So,
interesting to see where he is on the split.
So far, this run is pretty clinical. He's not really cutting the lines too tightly. He knows that he just needs to go smoothly.
He has to do something really special to come into the medals today. David Florence is second. He's only 0.82 down. The time to go for was 97.75. It's difficult bits to go.
Yeah, so you won't be aware of that time.
I think he got a little bit tied up in the boils there in gate 20. And there we
touch.
Go.
Well, Slovakia's taken a bronze, but we're not sure it's going to be Slavkovsky today.
No, I think it's Benes for today. Really, perhaps even a little bit too conservative there by Alex. As you said, looking very clinical, but just not having his usual flair.
Well, today we have a Frenchman who takes the first victory. Give a bit of confidence to his compatriots, not that they need it.
David back in the medals, that'll give him a lot of confidence going into the Worlds in America.
Well, that's what he did last year, isn't it? In Bratislava, he did quite well after not doing so well in the others, and then he certainly knows how to time for the big events like yourself. So, Denis Gagochanu takes the gold. There's the Polacek's, just with only four of them here, I think, this weekend, from Poland, saying hello, very close to us. David Florence from Great Britain. Results, as I'm just mentioning, Denis Gagochanu, France takes the gold. David Florence for Great Britain takes the silver. Matej Beneš for Slovakia takes the third, as we saw. Martin just missing out, and Slavovsky. So it's all together, it's really close. They change orders every single week.
Is that the first World Cup that Martin's actually missed out on a medal this
year? Yes.
So very impressive from him this year.
And then we're quickly moving on. Nothing stops. Fiona, how's your weekend so far?
It's been pretty good. The qualification didn't start too well. I had a quick time, but two touches in the first run, and then the second run I done another touch, and it ended up in 11th place, so comfortably into semi-final, ready for tomorrow.
Sounds good. And Robin, you all so far, you're on target for a special C2 performance?
Yeah, we were really fast yesterday, so we're happy with that. Few too many touches. We had three touches yesterday, but just wanting to give ourselves a bit of a heart attack in order to qualify for the semis, but job done, and we're looking to keep that speed going.
Well, statistically, the guests on a Saturday do well on a Sunday.
I like the sound of that.
That's the only reason I came in today, because you told me that. I'm really excited about this final. My training partner, Joe Clark, is racing third last. Came third in the semi-final, a pretty exciting run. And at such a young age, he's doing really well this season.
You told me you didn't really give him much choice when you spoke to him. You said you're going to be commentating, so you better be there.
Yeah, I did say to him last night, I says, I'll look forward to commentating on you tomorrow. And I think he got the message from that.
Yeah, some big hitters in this men's K1 final.
We got some guys who, it just shows, it's I'm an outsider, but it seems that the mental plays so much, because we have Hernandez, we have Nevu, and we have Combo, who each were on fire last weekend. They finished in the second to each other in La Seu d'Agel, and they've made the final again today. But there's the stacks of top quality that have missed out. Molmenti's missed out. Vavra Hradilek is coming back from injury, so probably quite happy with his performance, but he didn't actually make it. Etienne Dye didn't come through. Hannes Eigener didn't make it. So a lot of the big names haven't come through. But like you mentioned, there is pure quality, and it's great to have two Swiss in the final. I can't remember the last time we had two Swiss in the final.